Hi, I'm Alok. I'm a blogger, and my blog is thetimetravelers.blogspot.in or thetimetravelers.blogspot.com. With me, I have Chef Hay, who's the executive chef at The Spice It. I'm his chefer, and we have been staying here for a couple of days now, and every day we get to eat delicious and wonderful food from his kitchen. So, Chef, welcome to the show.
Yes, Chef. So, what are we making now?
We are making now sweet dessert called apple ki jalebi.
So I think it's very characteristic of Jaipur, which is a mix of the modern as well as traditional Jaipur.
Okay. For apple ki jalebi, we need apple peeled, corer. With the help of corer, we just scoop out of all these things. So we need approximately 6 mm thickness of the apple. So we need batter in which like the fine flour,
curd, maida.
Yes, maida.
Okay.
Curd for fermentation. No yeast in it. So it is a yeast free product. And a little bit of basil.
Okay. So
gram flour.
How much maida?
20 days, 250 grams of maida. And 50 ml of curd and 50 gram of refined gram flour.
Okay.
Just to give mildness of the curd.
And you mix it with water.
With water.
Okay.
And then ferment it overnight. Just keep it outside for fermentation. Fermentation required. So for making another dough, we keep the starter dough. It's called starter. So we add some other product without adding any curd in it. So this batter can keep around 1 month. So as it just gets old, the more fermentation, it will get a more taste in it.
So you leave it outside for 1 month, or you put it in the fridge?
In fridge.
Okay. So you leave it outside for 1 night and then you put it in the fridge?
Yes.
So that whatever ferment,
fermentation took around, in summer it took around 4 to 6 hours. In winter it's overnight.
Okay.
So winter is time approximately 12 hour to wait mature.
Okay.
In a pan, we add ghee.
Okay.
And
again, we are taking pure ghee.
Pure ghee.
Okay.
That. So we'll check.
So once it's the right temperature,
it's the right temperature,
it'll rise to the surface.
We put it off.
Okay. So once it's the right temperature, we put it off.
We'll put it off.
Okay.
So we do. So we will dip the apple in it and dip it nicely, and we'll hold it from the core part.
Okay.
So that batter get nicely coated on the apple.
So and you have to be careful, you don't want to
carefully put in the.
Okay, wow. So we have turned off the heat.
Yes.
Once the oil got hot enough, the ghee got hot enough.
So you can off and on.
Okay.
When you put something cold in it, so temperature will get down. Again, you can, if you feel that the smoke doesn't come up, so you can again on.
Okay, so check. So this we are doing, since we are using an induction heater, so we are doing it at the maximum.
Yes.
So once the one side is done, you flip it to the other side?
On the side, yes.
Okay.
You get the desired color. So in the same way, you can put it another way. And wait for time. Again, you just hold it from core part so that better get icy. Temperature is going up. We will sit it off.
Okay. So now, very nice.
You want to more crisp? So you can try more. It's almost done. So we'll turn.
So
our sugar syrup is ready.
Okay. So basically we have heated this.
Heated the sugar syrup.
Okay, till it has reached to the consistency of a one tap shot.
Yes. Okay. We are pouring in it. Nicely immersed.
Okay. I can see it's draped itself in that sugar syrup. Nicely covered.
So I'm going to add a cold rubbery on the top.
Okay. Cold rubbery onto horse apple jalebi.
Yes. You can see the color contrast, nice yellow syrupy on the base and white in the top.
I see this wonderful apple jalebi is ready, nicely garnished, smells so good. I'm sure it's going to taste wonderful, and I'm ready with my spoon. So chef, did you get started?
Yes, please.
Nice crunchy.
So you are getting a voice, it's getting?
Yes, it's nice, crunchy. I can hear the sound of when the my spoon cuts the jalebi. I'm gonna have my super
spoon. You get sound when you
kill you. You know, the flavor of the rubbery, and then I can feel the jalebi part of it. It has all the flavors. I can say it's a jalebi, it's a rubbery, but then when they are adding up, it's a very unique flavor and a very unique taste.
So in Western, people say apple fritter as well.
Okay.
So it is resembles where they don't put in immerse the sugar syrup. They top with some acacia honey on top, so that they get the taste of that, but very similar to that.
It tastes like a fusion dish. It tastes Indian, it tastes Western. So you get the best of all, both worlds when you eat this particular dish. Wonderful. Thank you very much, chef. And if you want to get more recipes like this, you can follow my blog, which is thetimetravelers.blogspot.com, and my YouTube channel as well. Keep following and travel the world with me.